change your dress before Aunt Elizabeth and Uncle Ben comes. It would never do for them to see you in colors.
What are they coming for? They haven't been here for ages.
They're coming to talk about poor grandpa's affairs. Your father sent them a telegram as soon as they found he was dead.
Good gracious, it's never them. Thank goodness it's father.
Mom, can you hear?
You can see the heaven, can't you? Now, Victoria, be after that quick. Put your white pearl with black sash.
I'm not satisfied, but we have done our best in our new blacks ready. And Ben Elizabeth will never thought of mourning yet. So, I shall tell them.
Get your boots off, Henry. Elizabeth, she's crying, she notices the least speck of dirt.
I'm wondering if they'll come at all. You and Elizabeth called last time, she said she had never set foot in your house again.
She'll come faster after her share of her grandfather's life. You know how chicken where she likes it? Where she gets them, I can't tell.
I suppose it's in your family.
What do you mean by that, Henry's letter?
I was referring to your father, not to you.
Where are my slippers?
In the kitchen. But you want a new pair? Those old ones are nearly worn out.
You don't seem to realize what it's costing me to be around and doing. My heart beats when I see the little slippers of grandfather lying around. And see, and think he will never use them again. Yeah, you did better with the slippers of grandfather now. It's lucky he's got a new pair.
They will be very small for me, my dear.
They will stretch, won't they? I'm not going to have them wasted.
Henry, I was thinking of the beauty of grandfather in his bed. I always wanted after he died.
You must arrange with Elizabeth before your wedding things up.
Elizabeth! That child, she will see him after it and she will drive a hard bargain over you. But hey, what is to have a low money grabbing spirit?
Perhaps she has got her eye on the bureau as well.
She has not yet since grandfather bought it. If it's only down here, instead of in his room, she did never get it deposit on her own.
Amelia!
Henry, why we couldn't bring that bureau down here? We could do it before they come.
I wouldn't care to.
Don't lose the draft. Why not?
It doesn't seem so delicate somehow.
We could put that shabby old chest of drawers where the bureau is now. Elizabeth could have that and welcome. I always wanted to get rid of it.
And suppose you came when we are doing it?
I passed on the front door. Get your coat off, Henry. I'll run up and move the chairs out of the way.
Will you fasten your frock up the back, Mother?
I'm busy. Get a father to do it.
What have you got your coat off for, Father?
Mother and me is going to bring your grandfather's bureau down here.
Aren't we pinching before Aunt Elizabeth comes?
No, no, my chair. Your grandpa gave it to your mother before he died.
This morning?
Yes.
He was strong this morning.
You mustn't say that he was strong now.
I think that his pencil is on as well. A clock's worth nothing has always happened to me.
That's grandpa's clock.
Shh. Be quiet, please.
Anna.
Henry, lift your head. Victoria, you're not to breathe a single word about the clock and the bureau to your aunt.
I thought we would pinch them.
Victoria, that's your aunt Rebecca, you're not to open the door.
Mother, it's them.
You're not to open the door till I come down. Let them knock away.
Mind the wall, Henry.
Did we knock much plaster off the wall?
Never mind plaster. Do I look all right? Just watch Elizabeth when she sees us in a half morning. Open the door, Victoria.
Yes, he's gone. He was 72 fortnight last Sunday.
Now, Amelia, you mustn't give away. We have all got to die sometime. Or other, it might be worse.
I don't see how.
It might be one of us.
It's taken you a long time to get here, Elizabeth.
Oh, I couldn't do it. I really couldn't do it.
Couldn't do what?
I couldn't start it without it in the morning.
We have ordered tasks, we'll be sure. I could not fancy buying ready-made things.
No, but for myself, it's such a relief to get into black. And now perhaps you'll tell us all about it. What did your doctor say?
Oh, he has not been here yet.
Not been here?
Didn't you send that at once?
Of course I did. Did it take me for the fool? I sent Renew's doctor, Pringle, when he was out.
You should have gone for another year, Elizabeth.
Oh yes, it's a fatal mistake. Pringle attended him when he was alive. Now Pringle shall attend him when he's dead. That's professional etiquette.
Well, you know your own business best.
Yes, it's a fatal mistake. Don't talk silly, Elizabeth. What good could a doctor have done? Look at the many cases of persons being restored to the left of the thought to be gone.
That's when they have been drowned. Your father wasn't drowned, Elizabeth.
There wasn't much of fear of that. If there was one thing he couldn't bear, it was water.
Ben, I'm sure he washed regularly enough. If we take a drop too much at times, we'll not dwell on that now. Father hasn't married this morning. He went out soon after the breakfast to pay his insurance.
My word, it's a good thing he did.
He always was thoughtful in that way. He was too honorable to go without premium. Well, he must have gone round to the Ringo Bells. Afterwards, he came as merry as sandboy. I says, we are waiting Henry to start the dinner. Dinner? He says, I don't want no dinner. I'm going to bed.
Oh, dear. And when I came in, I found him undressed, sure enough, and snug in bed.
He had a warning. I'm sure of that. Did he know you?
Yes, he spoke to me.
Did he say he had a warning?
No. He said, Henry, would you mind taking my boots off? And I forgot before I got into bed.
He must have been wondering.
No, he got them on all right.
And afterwards, when we finished our dinner, I thought taking some bit of something on the tray. He was lying for all the world as he was asleep. So I kept the tray on the view on the chest of drawers and went to waken him. He was quite cold.
Then I heard Amelia calling for me and I ran upstairs.
Of course, we could do nothing. He was gone?
There wasn't any doubt.
I always knew he would go sudden in the end. Will you go up and see for him or shall we have tea first? What do you say, Ben?
I'm not particular.
Well, then if kettle's ready, we will as may have tea first.
One thing we may as well decide now, the announcement in the papers.
I was thinking of that. What would you put? Add the sentence of his daughter to 34 upper convents, etc.
You wouldn't care for a bit of poetry?
I like, never forgotten, it's refined.
Yes, but it's rather so soon for that.
You couldn't very well. We have forgotten the day after I did.
I always fancy a loving husband, a kind father, and a faithful friend.
Do you think that's right? I don't think it matters whether it's right or not.
No, it's more for the look of the thing.
I saw verse in the evening news yesterday, proper poetry it was. It rhymed. Despised and forgotten by someone you may be, but the spot that contains you is sacred to thee.
That will never do. You don't say sacred to me.
It's in the paper.
You wouldn't say it speaks properly. It's different poetry.
Poetry classics, you know.
That will never do. We bond a verse that says how much we loved him and refers to all his good qualities and show what a heavy loss we had. You want a whole poem? That will cost a good lot. Well, we will think about it after tea and make a list of them. That's all furniture in his room.
There's no jewelry or valuable of that sort.
Except his gold watch. He promised that to our Jimmy.
Promised to our Jimmy?
I never heard of that. Oh, but he did, Amelia. When he was living with us, he was very fond of our Jimmy.
Well, I don't know. Anyhow, there's his insurance money. Have you got the receipt for the premium he paid this morning?
I have not seen it.
Mother, I don't think Grandpa went to pay his insurance this morning.
He went out,
but he not went into town. He met old Mr. Tattersall down the street and they went off past St. Philip's Church.
To the Ringo Bells, I'll be bound.
To the Ringo Bells?
The public house where the John Shaka widow keeps. He's always hanging around there. Oh, if he hasn't paid it?
If he hasn't paid it, was it overdue?
I should think it was overdue. Something tells me he's not paid it. I have a warning, he's not paid it.
The drunken old beggar.
He done it on purpose, just to annoy us. After all, I have done for him. Having to put up with him these 3 years, it's nothing short of swindling. I had to put up with him for 5 years.
And was always trying to turn in humor us all the time. But we don't know for a certain that he has not paid the premium.
I do. It comes over me all at once that he hasn't. Victoria, run upstairs, there's a bunch of keys that's on your grandpa's dressing table.
In grandpa's room?
Yes.
I don't like to.
Don't talk silly. There's no one can hurt you. We will check if it's locked up in the bureau.
In where?
In this thing? It's new since last I was here. Where did you pick that up, Amelia?
Henry picked it up one day.
I like it. It's artistic. Did you buy it in auction?
Where did you buy the Amelia?
Yes, at an auction.
Oh, second hand.
Don't show ignorance, Ben. All artistic things are second hand. Look at those old masters.
Crazy.
Don't talk silly. Don't tell your grandma's dead.
No, God is getting up. I saw him.
You do better go up and see for yourself, Amelia.
Here, come with me, Henry.
Shh. Listen.
Hello, what brings you here? How's yourself, Ben?
Grandpa, is that you?
Of course, it's me. What the devil do you mean by this storm pulling?
He's not dead. Doesn't seem like it.
You've kept long enough, Elizabeth, and now you've come. You don't see. Oh, please to see me.
You took us by surprise, Father. Are you keeping quite well?
Eh, what?
Are you quite well?
I'm right enough. But the witch of Eric, I wouldn't mind that I'm not the first person to catch the cemetery. Henry, that looks not too healthy.
Well, I never.
Amelia, what did I do with my new slippers?
Eric, my heart, my father.
I haven't seen them. Why have you got them on, Henry?
I told you about the stress there. They were that new and hard. Now, Henry.
Stepping into dead man's shoes and such chest.
Oh, Grandpa, I'm so glad you're not dead.
Hold it, Victoria.
Eh, what? Who's gone dead?
Victoria says she's sorry about your head.
Oh, thank you, Victoria, but I'm feeling better. Why, when you're in mourning, and Elizabeth, and Henry, and Amelia? And Elizabeth, Victoria, who's gone dead? Is it someone in the family?
No, you know, Father. Ben's relation.
What, Ben's relation?
His brother.
What was his name, Ben?
Isaac.
Where did your brother Isaac die?
In Australia.
He must be older than you.
Yes, 4 years.
Are you going to the funeral?
Yes.
No.
No, of course not.
I suppose you've been waiting for me to begin tea. I'm feeling hungry.
I'll make.
Come along, let's be jolly.
Henry, give Grandpa some pie.
Glad to see you have a good appetite, Mr. Merriweather, although you have been out so well.
Nothing serious, I've been just lying down.
Being asleep, Grandfather?
No, I wasn't asleep.
Could you hear and see, Mr. Merriweather?
Yes, but I don't remember seeing anything particular. Damn, Ben.
Of course not, Grandfather. It's all your fancy. You've been asleep.
Drag me inside, it's in my clock.
Well,
the hen.
What the devil has been going in his house?
I will tell you, father, what has been going on. Nothing short of robbery. Will not be caught. I call it double-faced.
No, Elizabeth.
And you, are you such poor creature to do every dirty thing she tells you? Remember me, well, Elizabeth.
Come, no quarreling.
My wife's every right to speak her own mind. Then I speak it outside, not here.
Damn it! Will someone tell him what's been going in his house?
I will tell you, father. Will not see you rob.
Who's been robbing me?
A maid and Henry. They have stolen your clock and bureau. They sneaked into your room at night and stolen them.
Speak for Elizabeth.
Will not be caught. After you are dead, I say.
After who are dead?
After you.
But I'm not dead.
No, father, but they thought you were.
Oh, that's why you are in luck today. It was a big mistake.
Grandfather!
It didn't take you so long to stamp dividing things up between you.
You must not think that, father. Amelia was just hurting simply hold on her own account.
You were always a keen one, Amelia. I thought the will wasn't fair.
Did you make a will?
Yes, it was locked up in the bureau.
And what was in it, father?
It doesn't matter now. I'm thinking of destroying it and making another.
Grandfather, not be hard on me.
I'll trouble you for another cup of tea, Amelia. Two lumps and plenty of milk.
With pleasure, grandfather.
I don't want to be harsh on anyone. Since your mother died, I have little part of time with you, Amelia, and a part of time with you, Elizabeth. So, well, I shall make a new will, leaving all my bits of things whomsoever I live when I die. How's that striking you?
It's a bit of a lottery, like. And who are you intending to leave it from now?
I'm just coming to that.
Father, you know, it's long time you came to live with us.
No, he's not with us as long as with you. I may be wrong, but I don't think father and fans living with you after what's happened today.
So you would like to have me again, Elizabeth?
Yes, father. I'm ready to make you home with us as long as you please.
What do you say to that, Amelia?
All I can say is Elizabeth changed her mind in these 2 years. You know, father, what the crime ritual was about? Amelia, don't be fool. Sit down. No, I'm not accepting you, Shanadar. Be quiet because Elizabeth said she's not going to keep you off her hands at any cost. She said she's enough to spend her lifetime with you, so we have got to keep you.
Seems that neither of you has any cause of trouble the way you have treated me.
If I've done anything wrong, I'm sure sorry for that, grandfather. And I can't say more than that too.
It's a bit late now. If you neither of you care to put up with me.
No, grandfather.
You both are saying this because what I've told about my money. If you don't want me, I'll go to someone that does.
Come, Mr. Merriweather. You have got to live with one of your daughters.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do on the Monday next. I've got to do 3 things. I've got to go to lawyer and alter my will. I've got to go to insurance office and pay my premium. And I've got to go to St. Paul's Church and get married.
What? Get married? It's all of his senses.
I say I'm going to get married.
Who to?
To Mrs. Johnson. Who keeps the Ringo Bell? We had fixed up a while ago, but I kept it as a prison supply. I thought I was a bit of burden to you, so I found someone who takes me as a pleasure. It's good, Amelia, you brought the bureau down. It would be handier to carry across the Ringo Bell.